You finally received approval to recruit that new millennial marketing intern to help with your Facebook marketing. Eagerly anticipating your newly acquired free time, you set down your coffee, log into Facebook, and head over to the account settings and try to invite them as a page admin. Your heart slowly starts to sink. You need to become friends with the intern to invite them to the page. But if you become friends, they're going to learn all about your 1960s troll doll obsession. What will the millennials think? But do not fret, there is a better way. It's called the Facebook Business Manager, and I promise it'll keep your secret troll doll obsession behind closed doors. Today, I'm gonna 1, give you an overview of the Business Manager, 2, show you how to get there and sign up, 3, run you through an overview of the interface, 4, show you how to share access with agencies and individuals, and 5, go over some common mistakes you'll wanna watch out for when setting up the account. I'm Adam Markfeld, owner of ParaCore, a pay-per-click lead generation agency. First things first, what is the Facebook Business Manager? Technically, it's a secondary layer to your Facebook account. It keeps your personal Facebook activity private, makes sharing and permissions easier when working with coworkers or agencies, and simplifies managing multiple ad accounts, pages, and payment methods. In order to get there, you want to head over to business.facebook.com and sign up for a new account. You'll need to be logged into your personal Facebook account, but you'll just need your company name and company email to register. So if you head over to business.facebook.com, you're going to see a screen just like this one. You need to actually log into your personal Facebook account. The Business Manager does use your personal account to authenticate you and attach to your profile, but it restricts everything within the Business Manager so people don't see your activity, they're not friends with you, they don't see all of your personal stuff. So if I go here and click Create Account, it's going to ask me to log in. And when I hit that, I'm logged into Facebook and now I can create a new account. So here I'm gonna do ParaCore Demo as my business name because we already have a ParaCore account. I'm gonna hit continue and then I'm gonna do adam.arkfeld@paracore.com. So here you see your first name and last name in your business email. The business email is what you're going to use to get notifications from the Business Manager, and it creates a separate login and notification system for just your business type of interactions within Facebook. So go ahead and hit finish. Once I've done that, now we see a different interface that you're probably not used to. In the upper left here, it has a menu for Business Manager settings, has Ads Manager once you add an ad account, and then the settings link. You also have Ad Account Overview and Business Settings. So once we head over to Business Settings, on the left-hand side, you can hover over these icons and you see pages, ad accounts, apps, pixels. You can bring all sorts of assets into this Business Manager. Here we see my user profile. You can also add new people. And up top here, there's a secondary menu, which is projects, partners, payments, business info, quite a bit of information. So if I head over to the ad accounts section, it says I don't have any ad accounts. So if you currently have an ad account, you can claim access to it, or you can request access to an ad account that maybe you don't have ownership of. So if someone set it up, or another agency, or someone else in your business has admin control over your ad account, you'll want to click this link. If you have access to it in your personal account and you're an admin, you can click this link. And then if you're just creating a brand new one, you can go ahead and click here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new ad account, and I'm also going to call this ParaCore Demo Ad Account, create the ad account. And I'm going to skip the permission section. Now we see that my ad account has been created on the left-hand side. The people assigned to it are me. And in the case of working with an outside partner like ParaCore or anyone else, you may want to assign a partner to this ad account instead of people. So basically, partners are companies that have access to your ad account and your pages and different assets within your Business Manager. So this allows you to easily share it out with third-party companies. Now you'll see after I click the link that I can select a role, typically select admin because we do quite a bit in your ad account. There's a link to share. If you copy this link and send it to us in an email, once we click it, we can then get access to this ad account. When you've sent that link, you're gonna see us in the partner section. It'll just say ParaCore right here. Now you'll also need to do the same thing in Facebook pages. I'm not gonna create a new page right now, but once you do create one or you have one or you claim it or you get access based on these three options here, you're gonna see the exact same interface that you're seeing with the ad account. Again, you're gonna want to assign the partner, send us the link. Once we accept that link, then we'll have access to your ad account and be able to run ads for you, access your page in the instance of pages. Now, if we're working with you on apps or pixels or product catalogs or Instagram accounts, the exact same rules apply. If you want to add people to your business manager, you'll want to head up here on the left-hand side, people. These might be people in your company or someone that's just doing a little bit of work for you that doesn't have their own business manager. And you can do add new people, enter their email, give them permissions, and then you can add the person. The reason we have you add us as a partner is because there are a number of people in our company that might be working on your ad account. So when you add a partner, we then have the ability to delegate processes and ad creation to different people without you having to add a bunch of different people to the account at all times. So again, there are a lot of different options. The most important things to remember are you have these links up here on the top and these links here on the left-hand side. Adding partners is incredibly important, and you do the assign partner. And then if you just need to add people within your company, that can be done up here. You need to claim your pages and ad accounts before you can share them out. And assuming you have admin control of those, then that should be pretty easy to do. There are a few common mistakes you want to avoid when using the business manager. The first is that ad accounts absolutely cannot be removed from a business manager account. So if you're an agency and you set it up in your name, you can't ever transfer it to your client. If you're a client, you'll want to make sure the account is set up in your name and you share access to your partners. This restriction only applies to ad accounts. Pages can be removed and transferred between accounts as normal. Next, you want to make sure you add people to each page and ad account when setting up new campaigns. If you share the account with a partner, but not the page, that partner can't actually create ads because they don't have permission to manage the page. It's important to remember that. Finally, you'll want to download the Facebook Ads and Facebook Pages apps for your mobile device. The new business account doesn't allow you to manage ads through your personal account at Facebook.com. You now need to manage ads and pages in the Facebook Business Manager on a desktop, Facebook Ads app on your phone, and the Facebook Pages app on your phone. That's all today for the Facebook Business Manager. I hope you found the information useful, and don't forget to subscribe to the YouTube channel. We're going to be creating a lot more content just like this for marketers just like you.